murder that
fascism
was just bleh to me. So every syllable was just
I'm with North and that's it. I'm sorry, y'all.
I'm from the Midwest, sir.
There's a town in West Virginia called Big Ugly.
Yeah, it sounds gross.
I love these facts so much.
Dude, there were legit 5 jokes running through
my mind. Imagine right now where you come from. Big Ugly. Yeah, that checks out. That ain't surprising at all.
Big Ugly West Virginia.
Just look at your ID. Are you the mayor?
Because, like, even, like, out of context, it's just, like, Big Ugly West Virginia. It's like, hey, our state isn't that bad. It's like, no, I'm just saying a city. It's a place that exists.
Big Ugly, comma, West Virginia.
Oh, I would hate it.
Oh, legitimately.
Imagine you're a basketball star hailing from Big Ugly West Virginia.
Nintendo
absolutely knows about the internet Triton because like a couple months after the Bowsette thing happened, they changed the crown's description. It was just like, only Toadette can wear this crown. So it's just like, kill that noise.
Martin Luther King Jr. earned a C in his public speaking class during his 2 semesters in seminary school.
Who is that teacher?
Who's the dude?
Okay, is it a white teacher? And is that the reason why?
Let me see.
Who was the dude that... Because, you know, you got to wake up one day
and just
20
go,
years later.
That mom changed everything.
I gave him a motherfucking C.
He wrote the I Have a Dream speech in school. He's just like, why are you writing about dreams? Dreams are for children.
You'll never make it, Martin. This is trash.
Or does the dude wake up like, yeah, my seat incentivized him to get
fired? Him. Y'all know I was his teacher.
Yeah.
And I told him that I was pushing him to do better.
Apply yourself.
Oh my goodness.
You can go 1 or 2 ways with that way. Either A, I'm a fraud, or B, I'm inspiring people so hard that I inspired the civil rights movement. Just through my teacher.
It's just some like physicist teacher in like the 30s is like, oh man, I'm looking through all these old papers that I got, physics papers. Look at this D- I gave to this kid named Albert Einstein.
Oh, no, surely that can't be the same one.
Oh. Dude, imagine Stephen King in a creative writing class. Oh. C minus, sir. Your adjectives, I don't know what you're doing. A dog with rabies, what's up?
In Tupac in math class, the teacher just comes up. Tupac, what I tell you about writing raps in class?
You're not gonna make it with this. You need these numbers. Get some bucks in you. And then 4 years later, you gotta dance around to slip up. You wanna be close banging it.
You know I taught Sue Tupac.
Oh, dude, I would never sleep.
I'd be shaking.
The PS5 in a year has outsold the Wii U's lifetime sales.
Y'all leave the Wii U alone. Try his best.
Hey, consumers did.
Accurate. Yes, it is.
Early
yes,
adopter.
That's exactly what we're going for.
Oh, dude, I will never forget that woman with all them Wii U's in the back of her car thinking she was going to flip them boys.
Oh, someone tried to do that near you guys?
No, it was a viral picture.
Oh, okay. I don't remember that.
You never seen it?
No.
Oh, dude, I'll look it up.
I think I've seen this.
It's unfortunate. Let's see what else we got.
Well, actually.
Yep, all I had to look up was Wii U woman.
Wee you woman.
Oh, this is gonna get be good. Some. Get some, y'all.
Let's see, Wii U woman.
No, I already got a new one for you.
Oh, okay. Where's it going?
He posted it in chat.
Oh, okay.
Oh, no.
Scalper beautifully boned.
Oh, and those are like even. Ooh. Ooh. There's probably like two per box in the boxes behind her, too. In the Yikes.
That boy's in a backseat and everything.
Yeah, you can see him on the console. Dude, this is at least 10?
She's like, this is my retirement.
Yeah, she thought she was going to flip these for double, because remember, the Wii was having supply issues, so this is the next console of the Wii, mm-hmm. So why wouldn't I do it?
She didn't find it odd that she can buy in 15 of them?
Day one. In the store.
Yeah, I was, because of like what the day I went through trying to get a Wii when it first came out, where I lucked the fuck out, someone, by someone's generosity, which, where's that in this world? Where I was just so concerned about getting a Wii U day one, I just walked into GameStop, I'm like, you guys go Wii U's? So, yeah. Oh. Okay.
Yeah, and no waste there, bruh.
Yep.
Remember at my GameStop, they had a tower of them built just to be able to grab and go.
Yeah,
why? You ain't even gotta pay, pimpin'. Just go ahead and take it.
Because they thought it was gonna be another Wii situation where they were just gonna fly off the shelf. They probably overstocked and everything.
Oh, yeah, GameStop for real had that problem.
Please take these. We need to put the. We have another display that we need to put here.
$100 off, please, anybody.
Mm-hmm.
Can I get this keychain? Absolutely. And here's Scott. Your complimentary Wii U.
I'm good.
Wii U featuring the upcoming great title, Zombie U. Remember that one? That was one of their big
titles. They ported it to PlayStation.
Yeah, PlayStation 4. It was on PlayStation Plus.
I played it at a con. That was a fun game.
It was decent. I got it because it was a launch game.
I will just never forget that trailer. Everybody's just like, end? What?
Nobody cares. I remember Mike hyping that bush up. Oh, I remember. It's so innovative where you're just like, a zombie's coming and you gotta look down and go, shit, and try to get your thing, as opposed to pause, find item. Oh, I remember you hyping that bullshit.
Yeah.
Oh, wow, yeah. I'm having flashbacks to that now, too.
Oh, man.
It's a lot better in the Zelda games that came out for Wii U. Having the menu management there.
I minored in history with a focus on the development of Western European socialism. Not socialism,
every word of that
fascism
was just lit to me. So, every word, every syllable was just
I'm quick north and that's it. I'm sorry, y'all.
I'm from the Midwest, sir.
There's a town in West Virginia called Big Ugly.
Yeah, that's not surprising.
I love these facts so much.
Dude, there were legit 5 jokes running through
my mind. Imagine right now where you come from. Big Ugly. Yeah, that checks out. That ain't surprising at all.
Big Ugly West Virginia.
Just look at your ID. Are you the mayor?
Because out of context, it's just like Big Ugly. Hello, everyone, and welcome back to the Podcast of Stuff, episode 309, with Ralph literally skidding into frame at the last possible second.
I don't know what you're talking about. I've been here the entire time.
Mm-hmm.
Do not believe Mike's lies.
Yeah, mm-hmm, sure. Did you change your clocks? Is that a thing where you're from now? And he's muted.
He just hit his mic off. There you go.
There we go. Now
simple question. I don't know why he's hesitant to answer.
What?
Hello?
Yeah, there you
you're
go.
You're good. You're good now. Can you hear
Hold
us?
Hold on. Yeah, everything's fine. Everything's okay. Good. I'm not talking about.
Oh, he boy. Must have hit the mute button.
We are
There's
a
mute
week,
button?
We are a week out because I got the plague and we forget how to podcast.
What?
Me? It was the flu.
I was going to say, Mike getting sick is par for the course.
Yeah, but that's a low-level sick. Like, this was like a 8-9.
It's like, I got an illness, therefore I'm out for 2 weeks.
A minor cold hit that man. He's done. That's it. That's how this plays out.
Oh, yeah, it was just like, Thursday. I had went to a tournament, like, felt fine. As I got home from it, I was like, that doesn't feel good. Next day, I worked, went and got a haircut, and then, like, right after that, I'm like, I feel like shit. Took my temperature. I'm like, 101 degrees. I do indeed feel like shit. And then...
Thanks for confirming.
Yeah, and then just fever. I think Saturday, like, I got so much sleep that day, because it just... I tried to just, like, play games, you know? I was like, I'm sick. I'm just going to relax and do whatever. I couldn't focus on shit. It was like... My the couch that I have has, I mean, you guys have seen it, but for the podcast people, it has, like, just big cushions. And sometimes, like, they'll get, like, smushed and what have you, and then there's, like, a flat back. Literally, there's a couple of times where just, like, the thing was smushed down, and I was, like, watching something, like, I'm just gonna. It's just, like, my head was just, like, on the back of my seat rest, just... just conked out for an hour every so often.
Dude.
It was, I was, like, just, my body was just like, you sleep now. But, yep, just a big old flu. And then, yeah, basically, oh, no, actually, it was, like, we played Nick All-Stars. And then at the end of it, I'm just like, I'm pretty sure I have a fever. When it took my temperature, indeed I was, did.
I'm not that tilted.
Meanwhile.
Yeah, So, yeah, that was my my last week was just getting better. How was your guys' last week or so? Good, huh?
I don't remember.
It was a week?
Yeah, I guess it just nothing of note happened. Mm. And so it was just a week.
Yeah.
Probably just went to work.
It was just your light, basically. Which that was explained to us.
I don't have a light right now.
Yeah, he had a chandelier. It fell.
Mm-hmm. It's one thing after another for you, homie.
Oh, it's been a crazy 6 weeks for your boy. Crazy 6 weeks.
Like, but no kidding.
But hey, look at that awesome front lighting that totally working TV is giving them right now.
No, I brought the lamp from downstairs.
Oh.
Had to.
Oh, I thought that was just your TV.
No.
Okay.
Otherwise, it would have been pure Organization 13. Like, that would have been the realm of darkness.
That's what it's like. Oh, my goodness. That's what it's like if the light is off.
That changed.
Imprisoning me, all that I see.
I can see the shadow of DA moving.
I can't see shit. I couldn't see shit.
There was a shadow when he moved. That's about all I could see, like an outline of a person.
But besides, like, getting better, tuned in for your guys' stream. I saw Comey and I was just like, I gotta watch.
You didn't have to watch.
I did indeed have to watch.
That was a terrible video.
That was bad.
It's hard to talk negatively about that, it seems. Not impossible, but definitely hard, especially on YouTube.
Basically, the guy was like, I have social anxiety, but it went, like, too hard, and I couldn't relate. She should have just been able to talk, because I can talk. And it's like... I'm being kind of polite, too, I feel like, in that description.
Yeah, basically. It was a very bad video.
My favorite part, though, I love when I get a reaction out of you guys through comments. That's like, just like, if I'm there, obviously, to watch the video, but just like, I'm just trying to get something out of you guys too. And just the Octopus Man, it was like, he was a pedo.
together.
Never forget where we came from.
Yep. <It's>, the many steps that we have taken throughout.
Dude, have we taken that many?
Hopefully
there's,
enough.
Man, there's a few.
Hopefully at least 18.
Yeah. Yeah. All right. Oh. So there is quite a bit to talk about, at least that I have listed down. I'm sure there's probably shit that I didn't write down that if you guys want to talk about. But first, your weekly reminder, bi-weekly, but Black Lives Matter, Stop Asian Hate. Get your vaccines and boosters, please. I delayed getting my flu shot. Guess what happened? Ha ha. Wear your mask.
You didn't delay it. You were forced to delay it. You had a chance to get it. Then you caught a minor cold. Then you stubbed your toe. Then the wind was too strong one day. And then you got the flu.
Half of those things were true.
So you didn't neglect to. It wasn't anything in your control. Your body just said, nah, we got plans.
I'm glad you're giving me that benefit of the doubt.
I'd like to hope that's the case.
Wear your mask in crowded indoor places. Support Ukraine. Support LGBT rights. Support body autonomy. Pay your employees what they are worth. Fuck bullies and be good to one another.
Not possible.
Okay.
It's possible, it's just not likely.
Mm.
Not probable.
So, let's start with like some movie stuff. Has anyone here seen The Marvels?
I'm going on Saturday.
I was in the process of acquiring it.
Mm.
And then I went, I don't even want to do that right now. So I watched literally 40 seconds and went, no, I'm good. I rewatched the latest Rick and Morty episode.
Okay.
Did you see the interview that was done with Miss Marvel, where they asked her like how she felt about the movie's absolutely abysmal performance, and she just went, "That's not really a question for me. I did the acting. I showed up and did my job. If it's failing, go talk to Bob Iger."
Yeah, that's the attitude that you should have. It's like,
that's the coldest fucking response you could have had.
It's like, I ain't got nothing to do with that. People come to see it or they don't, and they didn't. So, yep. Whatever. I don't have nothing to do with the marketing, the writing. Yep. More than what I did. So
she had the best response.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Like, she literally said, I just work here.
She is literally the best hire since phase one. And I say that because there was a recent thing where just like, if Feige wants to think it's Earth 616, I'm gonna let him. But once I'm a little more established, I'm gonna have some questions for that man.
Cause she's a big nerd too.
Yeah.
Oh yeah.
She like, and then like, she's just like all in on this character considering
She's
playing her. She's writing comics for her. Just all aboard.
She wants Miss Marvel to be there for the next 10 years and her to be part of that.
Indeed.
Oh, yeah.
But yeah, it had the biggest drop off for a second weekend. 78%.
In superhero movie history.
Didn't it have the worst opening Flash in Marvel history?
Yeah.
Superhero history, period. It doesn't matter.
Jesus.
We're talking Flash. We're talking Daredevil. Now, like,
why do we think that is, though? Because it wasn't marketed terribly.
It's that...
I won't even call it superhero fatigue. It's Marvel fatigue, I feel like, specifically.
It's mediocre Marvel fatigue. The movie didn't look good. Back in the day, with the new shine, we could have a bunch of Thor 2s and people would still go see it. And at worst, it would be a moderate success.
Mm-hmm.
Now, you need to be a good superhero movie to prosper. If you're not good, it's just, you're not going to do anything.
It's in it, like they've made too much content. They've flooded their own market.
They've oversaturated, and I think that's the problem. Market, and now people can see the failings of the formula they present for their TV. Because
the thing is, like, who's watched Loki? Anybody finished season 2?
Oh, right here.
I have not yet, but I don't
Verdict.
Care.
Verdict.
I really liked season 2. The first half is pretty boring and not good.
It did that thing that it needed to do. It set up the entire second half. So that's fine. I'll take that. But that's what I'm saying is, like, it took a formula that is, you know, predates all modern cinema. It's like, okay, the first half is literally we're just laying groundwork. And the second half, we're going to blow your fucking brains out your asshole. Because that's what they did.
I really like
that. Holy shit.
Even if at the end of the day you don't think season two is good, it is entertaining and it will make you care. It is emotionally good.
The even last not, 10 minutes of dude, the last it's so episode, good. Bro. It's so I was good. Like, that is writing.
Yeah, it's so
that is good. Acting. That is what Marvel and has been music, lacking.
Oh my God. Boy. I had to put Boy. The Loki theme on my playlist. Mm-hmm. I just yep. had to. I love that theme.
Just the way everything played out, the way they did everything, the acting, the character writing. Just the interactions between Sylvie and Loki at the end where she realized what he was doing. And then him climbing the steps and the fucking, the way they did the
horns. Hey, how about you not spoil things for people?
I'm giving visuals. I'm not saying what's happening.
And yeah, they're still going to know. There's a choice that Loki yep. makes that Sylvia may not want him to make. Oh, season boy. One. She's that's there season at one. The end. No that's, matter that's what. Season,
that's season one. I spoiled nothing, but yeah, I spoiled literally nothing. So I'm fine with it. But it's just like it's the really way good. Everything came through is so fucking well done. But that's what I mean by like the good is too far and in between at this point.
Yes. So DA and I don't know why we did this, but we looked at what was sandwiched in between like the recent Marvel stuff. And it was just like before No Way Home.
Yeah, it was dude was just like, if there's two or three bad Marvel movies, just don't go see the fourth one.
Yeah, the beginning section.
And it was stream. Eternals.
No, Black Widow.
Black Widow, Eternals. Black Widow, Shang-Chi, Eternals, and then Spider-Man. And we were just like, well, I guess
no, Spider-Man, Eternals was after Spider-Man.
No, it's Doctor Strange.
Oh, Doctor Strange yeah. was that. Jesus Christ.
Yeah, so it's just like, you can't go see Spider-Man because these three movies sucked. And they did suck.
Oh, and they sucked.
I don't want to hear about Shang-Chi. That sucked. But yeah, so I guess Spider-Man is out. So that was also a bad argument.
Yeah. And, you know, you have... So, you've also partially conditioned your audience to just wait for the home release of these things. to wait for it to come to Disney Plus. It's Disney no Plus. Longer must-see event movie type of stuff. Mm-hmm. It's I can wait 2 months. I can wait 6 weeks sometimes for it to just be in my home. There's nobody, quote-unquote, around the water cooler talking about the Marvels, talking about Multiverse of Madness. Like, America Chavez, what's going on with her? Who's talking about her? I love America. Ain't nobody saying before the Marvel started coming up, who's talking about Ms. Marvel? The another reason there's an issue is back in the day, you wouldn't know roughly either the characters would be talked about, they would show up in each other's movies, or there would be a short enough turnaround where you would know what's going on. The turnaround between the Ms. Marvel movie to the Avengers where she shows up to the Marvels all up is like 8 years. Like, what are we doing? So
that's how do you true.
And I feel like that's that's a symptom too of which is odd, like with what you're saying, but oversaturation in the sense of everything, where they're trying to shove in so many other characters in between. And, like, instead of kind of having, like, each movie just being their own condensed story, and then, you know...
leads into something else.
Occasionally, it will bleed into a few other things, but then it leads into a big group thing like Avengers. It's just, everyone's having, like, a very long, continuous story throughout multiple movies that you then need to keep track of, and then they keep shoving in more characters over here, and over here, and over here, and over here. And then you had, Yelena introduced over here, but then she's over here in Hawkeye and is going to be over here in the Thunderbolts and then over here in this. And it's just like, there's like 18 spinning wheels that you have to kind of keep track of now.
If you like that character, if you like that character, there's four or five different properties you need to watch. And on top of that, you look at, dang, what was I just about to say? It's lost. Don't even worry about what I was going to say.
And there's like even a couple of characters too that I wasn't aware.
oh, that's what I was going to say. I remember.
So, I haven't watched a good chunk of the recent Marvel shows, Secret Invasion and what have you.
It was terrible.
But I didn't know. Oh, and boy. Spoilers in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Maria Hill's just dead. Didn't know that.
Yeah. Yep.
Who is?
Maria Hill, who's been there since Avengers 1, has been like Nick Fury's right-hand man. Just gone. Didn't know. I read about it literally today.
Everybody was like, hey, is this going to be a Skrull? Is it going to be something else? Blah, blah, blah. No, dead.
So, like, cool. It's like, again, like all the things you have to keep track of for, like, in the next movie. And it's like, you know, a good chunk of people aren't going to keep track of, so there's going to be literally like 5 to 10 seconds of screen time, more than likely, in the next Avengers movie if Samuel Jackson's there, that they have to say, Maria Hill is dead. Like,
yeah.
It happened.
Or they don't, and she never gets brought up again.
Then you have things like, where is Moon Knight going to go?
Like, I forgot that show existed.
Yeah, what is his Dark role Avengers. In whatever plan there is for an Avengers, for a Secret Wars? Is he going to be in anything that's not Moon Knight? Mm-hmm. Who knows?
It's kind of been like, ever since Endgame, it's all just feel, because I'm looking at it again, Black Widow was a movie in the past. Shang-Chi didn't really have anything to do with anything so far. Eternals, Spider-Man, Doctor Strange, Thor, Love and Thunder.
You guys mentioned
Shang-Chi tried to tie the rings into that one alien race's tech.
The Chitauri?
Not Skrulls, the other ones. They tried to blend at the end of that movie that the rings were based off of, were an actual alien tech. I'm forgetting what race it was they were based off of, but that was the air quotes tie-in with that post credit scene they had. But that went nowhere, literally fucking nowhere. And that movie, hold on, when did Shang-Chi came out? Like 5 years ago? And we've heard nothing of that plot line?
Hey, remember the giant hand that's sticking out of the earth right now?
Yeah.
Oh yeah, there's that too. We haven't seen shit about that.
It's all bad.
Oh yeah. But then again, we're going to be told like, oh, these are all from different multiverses that are now going to be pulled in. And now we don't even know if they're going to keep the whole multiverse plotline as it is, because we don't know if they're going to keep what's his name?
Kang
going, which with the fucking way Loki ended, like, just, I want more. The guy himself is apparently not a good dude, but he played Kang fucking well.
He is a good actor.
Oh, dude.
That is the beginning and end of my praise for him.
Correct. The character was great, so I don't know what they're going to do next, but I mean, the other big problem Marvel has is actually in their marketing to some degree, because it feels like every single property they're putting out, this is the game changer. This is the game changer. This is changing
like
the game.
Other Marvel
You've
films.
Never seen something like this from Marvel before. Has literally been in 10 headlines.
Everything's changing the game. If everything's changing the game, there's no game. What are you saying?
Because if you look at it, Black Widow, Shang-Chi, and Eternals had a secret society that was actually ruling over everything. You can't just keep doing that.
No.
That whole, you know, if it's the best ever, if it's whatever, that's something that happens in wrestling a lot, where they're like, I've never seen, this is the greatest WrestleMania, and every WrestleMania is the greatest WrestleMania. Uh-huh. Yeah. I've never seen carnage like this when you just had a death match 2 months ago. It's, even though I've never seen carnage like Swerve and Hangman, that match was brutal.
Not even a Mick Foley match?
No.
I don't like garbage matches.
It's
it told the line of an actual match in a garbage match. It's not like a GCW where it's just
but you're stapling stuff to people's faces.
Dude, that was so good.
Like, this isn't wrestling.
That was so good because
at this point, why don't you just bring out a sword and cut the man's in half?
Dude,
come on now.
Swerve broke into the man's house, so he took a drawing from his kid and stapled it on his face. That's such good storytelling.
Okay, but you're gonna come out in your approved wrestling gear to your approved wrestling music?
No, he did not come out to his music.
Ancient match.
Nope. Swerve came out to his music and Hangman attacked him immediately. Okay, but
the other dude came out to his music expecting a professional wrestling match. It's dumb when you just go, yeah, we're gonna fork each other's eyes out, but also,
I mean, Swerve's a fing dirtbag. It's just like, I'm just gonna kill the guy anyway. I'll walk out to my music with literal dancers around me, looking like a fing boss. I love Swerve. Strap him up.
Okay. I just had it. Oh, actually, on the note of like. Future Marvel stuff, though. Thoughts on the Echo trailer?
It was good. But again, what? It's another one of those things.
you didn't see that.
Where is she going to go?
True. There was a trailer for Echo.
If they just went, hey, these characters are not going to be tied into anything. We're just giving you a good season of a series.
I have no interest in this.
It's got Kingpin, so...
I want to like it, but I have no interest. I hated that character. She was not interesting to me.
She was fine.
That's not enough to interest me.
Both Kingpin and Daredevil are going to be in it. There was a hint of Daredevil in it.
Where's Kate Bishop? What is she doing right
now? she's in the middle of nowhere training with Hawkeye. That's what.
Cool.
Explained away. All right, so bunch
I got
of
spoiled on the post credits of the Marvel. Couldn't give too.
Oh. I also couldn't give less of a.
And I
don't care about spoilers. What is it?
Spoilers: 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Beast comes back. Kelsey Grammer.
Wait, what?
Yeah.
No,
black girl goes into a different dimension and then just like, hey, there's Beast. Kelsey Grammer.
Yep.
Did they play the jingle again?
I don't know. I don't care.
Because I remember you were... One of you two was really pissed off about that jingle.
It was BG.
I was pissed about it in Ms. Marvel, and I was pissed about it in Multiverse of Madness with Xavier just rolling up.
Yeah.
You need that. You don't need that. What are we doing here? Are we saying...
How else
are
we supposed to know who that was?
The X-Men 90s in Xavier with the...
Didn't you see the chair?
Oh, I don't care.
That was
terrible.
Oh,
that
boy.
Was a great movie.
Boy.
Oh, your genes. There's some form of mutation.
That movie ain't got much, but it got that.
And that's what we're clapping for.
Of all characters,
you're the channel to stop clapping for.
Well, I mean, Wolverine is going to be in Deadpool, so you can't really use him. Like, Halle Berry is Storm. Like, who the hell else are you going to get? They already played the Xavier card.
Oh, yeah, they did.
They
will never come
back.
They screwed
her. No, yeah. She's not coming back.
So, like...
Unless they drop, like, 20 mil on her.
Yeah, who else are you going to get? And Frazier's not working.
Rogue.
So he's just like, yeah.
Oh, Rogue would have worked. Yeah.
Rogue. Cyclops.
Yeah, Cyclops. Jean Grey.
Again, they're all working. I haven't seen what's his face in anything. I think since his dumb cameo in X-Men Days of Futures Past.
Oh, what's the other guy's name? Gambit. Gambit would have been cool.
Who? From in what
X-Men Origins Wolverine?
Yeah, like, what?
No.
That's the only thing he's been in!
In that movie?
You forgot Gambit was in X-Men Origins Wolverine.
There was 50 people doing 50 things for
There's
50
no
seconds.
Other live-action Gambit. Who the fuck else do you... Who are you talking about?
I forgot he was even there. I'm just saying, you cast somebody as Gambit.
Okay.
I remember the two old ladies. The two old people. There's somebody I'm forgetting. Is it Gambit?
There's 50 people you're forgetting.
Horribly de-aged Patrick Stewart. You're forgetting that?
Oh, yeah, buddy.
Oh, he looks terrible.
Uh-huh.
Where's the color?
Yeah,
this
the X
lasted longer.
Before
they had
because,
the technology.
Yeah. This is good. The X-Men are trying to be the savior for sure.
Look at his muff. Is it a trench coat?
Oh, you're talking about Gambit. Yeah, no, Gambit was terrible. I thought you meant the de-aging of...
Yeah,
that's
the whole
terrible.
Push has been X-Men for a while now. X-Men is going to change the game again.
Once again.
One of the ads for the movie, there was text that faded away, but the X lasted longer.
Yep. Because it literally said, what's next? And the X remained. I saw that trailer.
Gotcha. Cool. All right, some trailers for some other things that came out. One, teaser trailer for Arcane Season 2. No, you two haven't watched it. I really like Season 1. I am super hyped for Season 2.
I can't wait.
We got a trailer. We finally got a look at the live-action Avatar. I think it looked really fucking good.
I mean, aesthetically, yeah, it's working. We'll see how everything works.
I saw you post it, or I forget where I saw it. You said you had qualms. What are your qualms? I'm curious.
Who?
You.
Oh, I mean, I have concerns more than qualms. I'm unsure how this is going to play out. It's just... When the fact that the creators of the series had to dip set from this project because they weren't being respected makes me nervous.
But that we don't know exactly what that means. That could mean that
that's what I'm saying. That's why I said yes.
That it could be like, hey, there's some changes that we want to make to the original thing that we think that could make it better. It was stuff that we wanted to do based upon things that we did in the future, so we can now incorporate it better here. And they're like, no, we think we can't. So we don't know exactly what that
means. That's what's still weighing on my mind when it comes to this. Like, it looks okay, but I don't know.
To me,
things like Yu Yu Hakusho exist. I can't give anything.
See, that's a little different.
No. You can't even. There's no comparison there.
I can't give everything credibility
there.
Until I see how it plays.
So from what we have been presented, all the characters look good. The bending looked good. There wasn't a fire pot next to somebody where they had to... And then the fire came out. There wasn't slow-moving rocks going across the screen. All looked good.
I missed
good.
The choreography. That was great
the
shit.
The last shot where they were flying does not look good.
The CG looks a little weird, yeah.
I thought most of the CG looked fine.
Looked a little off.
Because to me, like... Hey, when we first saw the trailer for One Piece, the Sea King didn't look great either. But, like, still, in its total, looked good. One Piece did. It was just, like, the combination of everything, the aesthetics, the actual set pieces looked good, and then the fucking music kicked in. And that's what I was just like, all right, you got me. So, I am looking forward to the show a lot.
I just hope they keep the characters, you know, the characters, and don't try to change things up.
So, I didn't write it down, but yeah, the Yu Yu Hakusho trailer.
Oh my god.
I saw a couple people online, they were like, this looks great! I'm like...
Hold on, what do you say?
Turbo fumble!
Oh dude, hyper fumble. The fucking spirit gun animation at the end of the trailer, bro. It is over. It is over.
I don't like how anyone looks.
I don't
save know. For Genkai and Botan for one shot.
I can't imagine trying to do worse than Kurama looks and accomplishing it.
It's looks comical. It's terrible. Farcical.
Dude, it looks like fucking I forgot the Toguro fucking brothers or whatever the fuck they're called. I'm fucking sort of distant from that series at this point. It kind of seems like they're fighting those two for the relics.
Yeah, I said the same thing. Yeah,
dude, that's how this is looking.
It feels like they're mashing two storylines together to set up the eventual Dark Tournament return.
It's not making it to the. It's not making it there.
It shouldn't. It doesn't deserve it.
It's not making it to Dark Tournament, bro.
Wait. Is it this scene you said Botan looks good in?
I said there's one scene. I don't know if it's that scene. I don't know what you're showing.
And also...
no.
Also, no, I don't think he looks good either.
Not the scene. No. Don't put that on my neck, homie. Don't you disrespect me like that.
Dude, there ain't a single bit of this that looks acceptable.
Gekai looks good.
I'm fine with the wig.
Dude, what the? This is a woman's wig they just plopped on this man's head and was just like going out there and act. They literally went to the dollar store, bought a wig, cut some bangs into it, and went, "Let's go."
That looks horrible. It looks really bad.
It's a really bad wig.
Yes. Holy Christ.
Oh my God. He looks terrible.
Oh, here we go. Here we go.
Oh, dude. Oh, this looks so bad.
They look fine.
No, my biggest thing is that's clearly he's clearly CGI on the shoulder. Yeah. Homeboy looks like he's 5'11", maybe.
Yeah.
And we got Weegees here. Your guy looks good.
She's just old lady, dude.
Kuwabara looks the worst.
I hate him.
Oh, yeah, let's all attack Tagoro. Because that's what we do.
And they're going to do the dumb wrestling spot. That's so one of the dumbest things. Where they all just gather on somebody. And the big man just goes, raw. And they all fly off.
Oh, and there's going to be slow-mo. And they're all going to be twirling in the air. Oh, my God. This is going to be terrible.
The slow hands out, fade back.
Yes. Dude, this is exactly what I expected One Piece to be.
Oh, yeah. Full on. Like, I fully expect him to lose to Toguro, and that's what brings him to Genkai.
Oh, dude.
That is how I see that playing out.
Oh, don't.
They are fucking. That's how I see this playing out.
Oh, this is terrible.
I'm fine with story changes like this. It just. They just look like trash. Kuwabara looks stupid.
He looks horrible.
He's also blonde.
Man,
they didn't even try, they're
going in a different direction with the whole they're not looking one for one, they've got the inspirations of the characters. Mm-hmm. And just do it.
Mm-hmm.
Mike, I am super shocked you do not have MAPPA in this thing description, this title.
Of course he doesn't.
I kind of forgot.
Crunch, homie. Animator, crunch.
They ain't getting a Sensui. What are you talking about? And if they do, he's just going to look like some guy.
Which he does.
Sure. He's going to look more like some guy.
The animators for MAPPA have been burned out. They're working unbelievable hours. And literally, Jujutsu Kaisen, that thing.
Mm-hmm.
Worse than the standard terrible anime production schedule.
Way worse.
They did the equivalent of what would be 4 years of work in 6 months, if I read that correctly.
Something like that.
On Jujutsu Kaisen Zero movie.
Yeah. They did 4 years of animation work in like 6 months under crunch. Like they never left the office.
It's equivalent to the Call of Duty that came out, because these games should take like 3 years minimum to make, and they had to make it in 16 months.
Yep.
Mm-hmm. car.
That's why these things come out so broken. But the fact that the Jujutsu Kaisen content is as good as it is, if the team was given an accurate amount of time, the fact that it could be better, despite it already being good, is almost sad, because it is already good. If they had more time to put polish on, could you even imagine? It would have been insane.
It's one of those things where, and again, I don't know the labor laws in Japan and what have you, where it's just like they desperately need a union, but it's not going to happen.
Yeah. Japan is, as a culture, and DA, he said it, it's not to be xenophobic. They're very, hey, you're going to be working 16 hours, and that's just the way we do things. Mm-hmm. There's sleep pods across from offices. There's beds in offices. Like, this is just the expectation of working, like, in these types of industries.
Mm-hmm.
Did anybody see or read Zom 100 yet?
No.
So the team that made that series because they broke off from working on Pokemon, which had also abysmal crunch. And that was like the entire main character's focus in the first episode, was that he was literally fucking miserable because he worked for what they call a black company, a company that slaves you the fuck out. So they made that company because they wanted to get away from a crunch company, and they made that the base theme of their main character. That's how bad it is.
Was there crunch on that show too? I feel like I read there was yes, still there crunch was, on that show.
And that's the fucking funny thing. I say funny, but heavy air quotes.
I don't know if you're talking to us or not. Oh, you're talking to your one of your brothers.
Yeah, two of them just came in. It sounded like one of them had his girlfriend, and we're like, we're doing a podcast. Don't
do it. Okay, next up on my list. Pedro Pascal is in talks to play Mr. Fantastic.
I don't think it's a good role for him.
Like, can he do it? Yes. What was that?
No, it's not us.
Okay. Can he do it? Yes. Should he do it? I don't think so.
Probably not. Will he do the role fine? Yeah. He's a good actor. He'll be able to handle it.
But it's not about the actor, it just doesn't feel like a good fit.
Yeah,
there's a
I agree.
Lot of people that wanted Glenn Howerton. I think that would be a great fit.
Who they killed off mercilessly in Multiverse of Madness?
No, that was somebody else.
No, you're talking John Krasinski.
That's what. No, I'm saying that they wanted John Krasinski. People wanted John Krasinski.
Why? He was fine.
People wanted him. And that was like one of the big things where it's like, oh, they actually cast him as Mr. Fantastic, and then they killed him, and that was it.
To me, it would be like, okay, Tom Cruise is a good actor. I couldn't see him as Iron Man.
Yeah.
I couldn't see him as Captain America.
I could not see him as our Iron Man, but the villain Iron Man? Yeah, I could see that.
I couldn't see him as Captain America.
No.
No.
I couldn't see him as he'd probably do fine as Bruce Banner, but like, he's a good actor, but it's just not the role.
No, I agree.
Tom Cruise plays, and this doesn't feel like the role he should be playing.
Mm-hmm.
I think he'd do better as Dr. Doom.
You know, he's used to playing a role where he does a lot of body acting versus facial acting at the moment.
Well, he also hated that role, though.
The Mandalorian?
Yeah, he's on record as saying he hates not having his face out. He hates the helmet. And he has fought for every ounce of screen time he can get without the helmet on.
Gotcha.
Don't join a show where the whole thing is they can't take off their helmets.
that is fair.
Hey, I want the job, but I want the job to be different.
Change
their entire culture that's been existing for some 30, 40 years for me.
The Madam Web trailer. It exists.
It is. Hey, do you guys know that Kraven is coming out soon? I feel like this is going to be another one of those things where it's going to be 2 weeks after release and you're going to go, oh, that's out?
Mm-hmm.
Right. And then maybe on a Tuesday when you're bored, you'll go, let me go see this trash.
Oh. Hey, Ralph.
The balls that it took to release this pilot episode of a CW show in theaters is enormous. You know what? It don't look great.
No. It's... That's honestly probably the best description that could be about this movie. Very succinct, DA.
It looks fine.
It exists.
Fine. But trailers are meant to sell you on a thing. And this does not sell me.
Yeah.
It just looks fine.
So, yeah. We'll see more of that. Scott Pilgrim Takes Off. That came out.
I need to watch it.
This past weekend. I won't say too much about it. All I'll say is it was not what I was expecting. I was initially disappointed, but then the rest of the show, good stuff. Really, really like it. You can tell the cast is really happy to be back. And I actually I saw some behind the scenes, because you mentioned Captain America, and I just remembered this. It was Chris Evans was doing some kind of interview going over a bunch of the big characters that he's played over the years, and he went over Lucas Lee. And apparently that entire cast of Scott Pilgrim is still just super close to this day, and all of them are that was the favorite movie ever, most favorite movie I've ever worked on. It's my favorite movie I've ever worked on. It was so fun. And apparently they all still keep in touch with one another, which...
There's a group chat, he said. Yeah. Mm-hmm. I saw that interview too. Mm-hmm. There's a group chat where I think what's his name hasn't interacted the guy who plays Scott Pilgrim,
Michael Cera.
Yeah, Cera hadn't used the chat for almost a year, and he just popped up and said one thing at Christmas. Was like, where the fuck have you been? I was just like, you know, that's when you know your friends.
But yeah,
that's good shit.
Go watch it if you haven't. If you liked the movie, if you like the graphic novel, I think you will like this show.
Just recognize that is different from both of them.
Yes.
A lot of people are going into it not recognizing that.
Yes. And that was the initial disappointment.
As in it's not the same as the comic or not the same as the movie?
Yes.
Both. They expected a more faithful adaptation of the comic, but as an anime. Or they expected the movie stretched out, but as an anime, and they got neither.
Mm-hmm. But
interesting,
I will say what we get thing. Is good. It is its own thing, and it is very good. That is all I'll say. We can, if we all watch it, maybe next week we can talk about it. But
how did you not watch the movie? It's a good movie, Alfonso.
What? Dude,
yeah,
that
need to see the movie.
That movie was on religiously for me. One, the actual menu music is kind of relaxing. I've fallen asleep to that menu music a lot. But yeah, just the movie itself was good. After I watched the series, I rewatched the movie, and then I listened to the commentary tracks of the movie. That's how much I liked this movie. And then reread the graphic novel.
I should rewatch that soon. I need to watch the series and watch the movie again. It's been too long.
It should have done better than it did. It just didn't grasp people, but it's a cult classic. I feel like the audience that it has, people love the movie.
Yeah. It was definitely one of those, right place, wrong time movies.
I forgot the video game too tells a different story. Every single medium of Scott Pilgrim tells a different story.
Okay, but that's very Scott Pilgrim. I'm not, you can't even, lie. That's on brand for that entire story. So I'm not mad. Okay.
All right. And then we got an announcement that we are getting a live-action Legend of Zelda movie, ironically made by Sony Pictures. I found that kind of funny. That's all we know. I think there was a director, but I don't necessarily care. My whole thing is they're going to have to make Link talk. And how are we going to get around that fact? That's the only thing I care about right now. We're not going to see it for another 4 years.
British accent, just like Zelda and Breath of the Wild. They're all going to speak British.
I can't wait for that first trailer.
They're
either gonna come out the gate swinging with him talking, or they're gonna tiptoe around it for the teaser, and then it's gonna end with like, Link, don't you have something to say about this? And they're gonna cut to him, and he's gonna open his mouth, and it's gonna The Legend of Zelda. Cuck y'all out.
No announcement of who's voicing him. Nothing.
Well, no, you're gonna see. It's an actor. It's live action.
Yeah. No.
Nothing.
I want nothing.
It's just gonna be his back, and he's just gonna be standing up, and that's all.
So they're gonna be literally Luke at the end of The Force Awakens.
Greatness. Oh, I can't wait.
But, just why is this really needed? Was anybody calling
for this? Somehow Ganondorf returns.
Dude, people have been asking for a live action Legend of Zelda for a very long time.
Like, at the end of the day, too, it's just like, he's going to talk, so people are going to have to get over that, myself included. Make him not a fucking shit brain like he has been in every single incarnation that he has talked.
Well,
don't make him.
Excuse me, princess.
Don't make him a little dickwad, and I think you're halfway there.
I hope they have that line in there. I hope they have that line in the movie.
Just remake Luke. Just remake Luke, and you're like, you're basically there. Just a hopeful youth.
Mario.
Kind of, but like, again, just hopeful youth. That's. Again, just don't make him a little asshole, because you get
more than that.
Like, maybe make some references. Like, I feel like people would still like that. Where it's just like, if like there's, you know, some sourness between him and the princess, and like under his breath, he's like, well, "Excuse me, princess." Like at that point, it'd be
keep it.
No. I'd be okay.
We all that's the same way I felt about the FNAF movie. We all know we don't need to do it. We know what we're here for. We know that. What does it do for that being
theory.
In the movie? That does nothing. You know the
fucking
thing. You don't need to be fed the thing. No. Kill that.
That's the one thing I'd be okay with in terms of reference of the one of the two times he's talked. Don't do anything from Zelda CDI, please.
Nah.
How about a kiss? I won! Boy, at some point I do need to play those on stream.
The fact that it's coming now, the fact that it's happening, it's happening only because Mario did as well as it did. So now they're.
Well, no, they
the
said they've been working on it for a very long time.
Yeah, it feels like it's just pushed to other media, and Mario came out first. That was the first push, and then it's the next push. And then they're probably gonna do a Samus one, whatever. All in.
Oh God, who would they?
Smash
who would they cast as Samus? That'd be an interesting one.
I feel
Brie
like
Larson.
You know what? I feel like she'd be do better as Sam. Like, honestly, take her character of Captain Marvel and just put her in the Samus suit, and I think it's a better character.
It probably would have worked better for Samus.
Mm-hmm.
I wonder who they're going to get to play anybody in the Zelda movie. This is.
I know there was an actress
with the already looking like she has elf ears.
Yeah, where she's like, yep. I would kill to play Zelda.
Yep, she wants it. She dresses up as Zelda. She wants it bad.
Which,
petitioning for their role.
You know what? If they pull a fucking One Piece where it's like the entire cast is like, get me the fuck in here. I want to be in the Zelda world. You know what? I'm all for that.
I hope they give Zelda a cameo of some kind. That would be cool. I agree.
Oh, Zelda Williams?
Being that she was, yeah.
That'd be cool.
Being that that's what her namesake is, and Robin Williams is Robin Williams. I feel like that would be one of the coolest things you could possibly
also,
do.
Also, before I looked at chat, I was going to be like, a cameo in her own fucking movie? I got very confused for a second, and then I read chat. We're good.
We're getting there. But yeah, no, that'd be awesome. I agree.
We're not going to see anything for a few years because it's like literally they're starting production.
If Chris Pratt is in the movie, what so fucking ever? I swear to God, I'll lose my mind, and I think Mike might kill himself. Don't wish that on
it's
him.
It's so weird. Why is he Garfield?
Bro, that is awful.
His absolutely voice is not terrible. Good for Garfield.
End it. No, I watched that
voice.
And saw the behind the scenes of him recording. I'm like, dude, you're not even trying. Dude, what is happening here? How can he keep getting away with this?
With this mediocrity.
Why?
He is a name. Unfortunately, not he is enough. A name.
Not enough.
I feel like a lot of people were throwing out Tom Holland for Link, where it's just like, while
no.
not bad, still no.
No. I would be totally fine with a full cast of relative unknowns.
Same.
Oh, agreed. Yeah.
Same. Two more things from movies.
Keep the star power out.
This whole Roadrunner movie fiasco, where
bury it for taxes.
They announced that Warner Bros.
Politician going, get involved.
Yeah. Warner Bros. Was announcing that they were going to shelve this movie just for a tax write off. Internet went up in storm because and a lot of the cast went up in storm because apparently like the cast was actually really jazzed about this movie. All the test screenings mm-hmm. apparently were actually very positive.
We saw behind the scenes of the people making it and they loved working on it. And then mm-hmm. it's just like, all right, we're going to show you guys the finished product and then it's going away.
Mm-hmm. But then obviously the internet kicked up a storm. Some politicians were thinking of trying to get legislation passed to penalize studios for trying to just like make these movies for tax write-offs. And now Warner Bros. Is deciding to shop the movie around, see if anybody else wants it.
We was playing. We was going to release it this whole time. And they were going to write it off for $30 million.
Mm-hmm.
Uh-huh. I think it's very good that they were just like, yeah, you can't just keep doing this. We're mm-hmm. we're stepping in. That's scummy.
Mm-hmm.
Meanwhile, if they got enough losses, the taxes are lower.
Yeah. Like, Dwayne Johnson for Captain Falcon. Oh, please. Oh, please.
Can you smell what this Falcon is punching?
They can't even put out a game for Falcon. They're not. And you think it, I don't see how they keep innovating with Mario Kart and then with Captain Falcon.
You know,
like,
though.
We got no idea.
You know, though, a Need for Speed, or not Need for Speed, sorry, a Fast and Furious style movie with Falcon, if the F-Zero franchise, might kind of hit. It might kind of hit.
Is Vin Diesel? Vin Diesel is Captain Falcon?
Oh, no.
That'd be funny. It'd be awful. It'd be funny.
Is like Twisted Metal for Captain Falcon.
To who?
Twisted Metal. Do that for Captain Falcon.
Mm.
It was a good TV show, and more people should watch
Jason
it.
Jason Momoa? I could see that. This Cap.
Yeah, I could see it.
I don't think he's earnest enough. Like, I need a really earnest dude.
Like, who's that exuberant, though?
True.
Come on!
Yeah, I need a really...
It makes no sense.
I don't think of somebody.
And then the final thing. So, we had announced that SAG-AFTRA, I think we did, had agreed to a tentative deal. However, a good chunk of actors are kind of seeing, at the very least, the cliff notes. They have, a good chunk haven't seen the full deal yet, but they've seen the cliff notes. And a lot of people are less than enthused.
Yeah.
There will be a vote to approve the deal. I'm hoping, from what I have seen so far, that it does not pass, and then they go back on strike. Because there's a lot of stuff apparently that is still not protecting from AI. there's I think there's like one of the big things was like you can still like basically you can say I don't want AI, but they didn't eliminate I don't want my voice being approved to be used to train AI. But there's an option for actors to do that. So studios then are empowered to be like, I'm not hiring you that doesn't want to do it. I'm hiring you that does. And so that's just going to create a whole bunch of problems there. And then there's just a lot of vagueness, apparently, in the verbiage in terms of AI. I guess, too, while you were living, were like, I don't want my voice used. I don't want my voice used. The minute you die, other people can decide for you. The estate basically can decide for you. So there's just like not a whole lot. Jim Carrey as Captain Falcon. No.
We need a this generation's Jim Carrey.
Channing Tatum? That maybe. but yeah, so there's a lot, especially voice actors are not happy so far with everything that has been shown.
They are always getting the shorty end of the stick.
Mm-hmm. All right. Now,
how it goes.
On to games. One, I saw a depressing thing. It has been 10 years since the PS4 came out. We're old. Mm-hmm. Moving on. There was a very big game that came out this past Friday. I know. Everybody's super excited. Bluey, the official video game, came out. Really, really.
And really. Xbox is running a whole sweepstakes for a Bluey Xbox Series X.
It's dumb in a good way. It looks dumb
and
in a good
I
way.
I hashtag kind of want it.
Naturally.
But Mario RPG came out. I have yet to play it yet. I never played the original, too, so I'm actually very excited to actually.
What are you doing?
It was one of those old games that went under my radar.
I would assume you consumed everything, even quasi-big, from Nintendo back in the day.
No. Especially, crazy. That Super NES area. Not so much. Maybe after, N64, but not so much before that. Nick All-Star Brawl 2 came out. DA and I both played it. Very fun. It's the way I described it while we were playing it is it's flipped Smash Bros. Where for Smash Bros, the menus, the interface, everything surrounding getting online to playing a game is very clean, very good. But as soon as you hit them on that online, lag, input delay, all that fun stuff, just game performs terribly when you're online. Nick All-Star Brawl, boy, them menus and connecting to somebody and sometimes the game just glitching out. All everything surrounding being in the game, not great. It's pretty scuffed. The moment you are in a game fighting each other, butter. Some of the best online I have played for a fighting game, period.
It's very good.
but yeah, everything else, there's a couple of times where we were just kind of stuck in the menu. There's one, I forget if it was you or if I saw it in another stream, where just the game started, but the map was zoomed out to 20% and we couldn't move. Or it's people could okay, that wasn't us.
That was at the at the victory screen. It just sort of
zoomed
out and we had to exit the
it was we're our characters. Obviously there's patches and stuff and there's still a lot of jank with some of the characters, but the game itself is actually really good. there's a lot of dirt with the slime mechanics. Go watch some of the highlights if you want to see high-level gameplay and what the game can be. The latest, the Slime Box, Hungry Box's latest tournament. There's wave shine combos. There is just a lot of dirt that can be done with the slime meter and all the different mechanics in the game. It's really fun. we got, speaking of fighting games, the full roster for Tekken 8 has been unveiled. And there was some discourse in the Discord about Reyna and who is Discord. Best girl.
No, there really isn't.
There really isn't.
Yes, there really isn't.
I want to see you two fight. I know you have I know you disagree now. Fight.
We fight all the time. How much can y'all get us fighting before it's just we just synced it?
Never. It will always be good.
I said my piece. Sometimes one sun must set for a brighter sun to rise.
I said no peace because no peace needs to be said.
I understand that and I respect it.
Thank you.
Yeah, Reyna does look really fucking good, though.
She, her,
the side-by-sides with her and Heihachi's moveset, like.
For, the, character to character, this is probably the best designed roster I've seen.
Oh, yeah.
Ever. They are.
Hashtag not Paul.
Paul. It's one of the. I don't know what they were doing with that.
How do you cook with 98% of the roster and then go hyper fumble the that
it's like
guy.
You got Reyna, you got, I'm forgetting her name, but Coffee Girl, and then they just decide Asusina to throw
put
Cyborg
respect on it.
They Cyborg Samurai Ninja Secret Agent Chevalier, like old
Ooh,
man daddy
older man in a suit, yeah. French guy.
Like, if I pick up Tekken 8, that's who I'm playing. I'm just like, this dude fucking is
they
awesome.
Just have really good designs, and I'm just like, The new characters, they look good. The redesigns, except for Paul, look good. It's the best designed roster I've seen.
And from what I hear, it plays very well.
Okay. I actually might pick it up. I've never really played Tekken, like, at all.
I am just not a 3D boy.
I played Tekken out a lot.
So
I
played more
younger.
Soul Calibur than Tekken. I think I've only played Tekken in arcades. I don't know if I've ever owned a Tekken. Excuse me.
I played the last Tekken, but my character was too good and it was boring. So
also, there is, I need to like work something out either like against UDA or BG. Apparently there is a PC mod out right now for Soul Calibur 2 that just adds Link, Heihachi, and Spawn. All three of them to the game.
Oh, yeah.
So it's the complete roster of Soul Calibur 2. yeah, definitely want to try and get
that.
Hey,
right now, Ultimate Marvel 3 is $7. And it is modded up the wazoo.
It's very fun seeing those mod tournaments.
It's the hype-ish. Except when Urien was really strong, and all you got was the reflector. It's just like, oh no.
Jet, make no mistake, Asuka is still on top of the mountain.
No, there's only one peak.
Well, suit. Okay. this is just a factoid that I found amazing, and it kind of makes sense why they've been pimping out Mario Kart 8 for the last however many years. Until last month, this past month, Mario Kart 8 was in the top 20 highest selling games for each month for 6 fucking years.
Yeah.
Just bonkers.
Yeah.
And they have
that's
like
an interesting bit of data.
Yeah, just like it has like from the Wii U into the Switch when it got re-released. And probably also is like both versions were selling for a bit too. The Last of Us 2 remaster. Anyways.
Can we stop?
No. No, we can't.
This would be totally fine as a free update. And then if people haven't bought it yet, it's like $40.
Mm-hmm.
It's gonna be $60. And it's going to be $25 if you already own The Last of Us originally. I would put money down on it.
And we've been here now in Last of Us land. Because I feel like it was Last of Us HD port into Last of Us 2 into Last of Us remaster into Last of Us 2 remaster.
Mm-hmm.
Right?
Nope.
Yep.
Last of Us remake.
Remake. I forgot. You know what? I even made the point of saying HD remaster because of remake, and I forgot to fucking say it. Yeah. It's been the same two games remastered / remade for the last, like, 6 years-ish.
Hey, you know what isn't? Factions.
Yeah.
I'm so hurt. They have a roguelike mode that's going to be just as fun. We guarantee you. Please, buy the game.
All right, Men's Warehouse. And finally,
furious.
Game Awards. We have the nominees. I have it pulled up over here on the gaming PC.
You better not rattle all of these off at 9 p.m. at night.
It's not going to be like every single thing. Mostly like the game stuff. I'm esports players and all that shit. I don't care. Game of the Year.
Oh, can I just say hashtag no Hogwarts Legacy, boohoo?
Yep.
All of it.
Or Final Fantasy 16, which I played it. is not in this list. This list is correct. It is very correct.
Oh, yeah.
We have Alan Wake 2, Baldur's Gate 3, Marvel Spider-Man 2, Resident Evil 4, Super Mario Bros. Wonder, and Legend of Zelda Tears of the Kingdom. Of the games that I have played, Baldur's Gate 3 and Tears of the Kingdom are the two that I think should win. I have not played Alan Wake 3 yet.
Bro.
I'm assuming. But of those two, those are the two that I think should win just of everything that I've played and what have you. But honestly, any of these games winning is not bad. Like, they're
yes,
all really
Resident
good.
Evil should not be up there anymore.
They're all
Resident
really
Evil
good
should
games.
Not win.
That's probably and the only because, one.
Not because it's a remake or whatever. It's just that it's to me, it's not good enough to separate from the original. Like Resident Evil 2, you can totally separate Resident Evil 2 and the remake from the original.
What would you put in its place, though?
I'd have to go through the games I play.
Like, the only
I'll
game
what
that
I wouldn't put in, that's Persona 5 Pet Tactica.
The only game
it's
I.
It's fine.
The only game I would put there that I have played this year is Final Fantasy 16. But I don't think it should be there above Resident Evil 4.
Honestly, I'd put Street Fighter.
That I could see.
There have been 10 versions of Resident Evil published since the game first came out. It's over. Let it go.
Yeah, but Skyrim remake.
Do you see? I have seen more Resident Evil talking points than I've seen Skyrim talking points.
Hi-Fi Rush would be another good one. Was that last year though? It's in different categories. Yeah. Okay. Best game direction. Alan Wake 2, Baldur's Gate.
What does that even mean?
Award, outstanding creative vision and innovation in game direction and design. I feel like this is just another way of saying like best game.
Like I don't understand.
Yeah, I don't know. Best narrative. This
Alan
should
Wake
be.
2. If Alan Wake 2 does not win that, there's something wrong.
It's between that and Baldur's Gate, probably.
No, Alan Wake 2 should win that. Baldur's Gate 3 should win Game of the Year. Alan Wake 2 should win Best Narrative.
Then Best Art Direction, it's between these two to me. For sure. Probably Super Mario Bros. And Hi-Fi Rush. Mario Bros. Looks so fucking good. Just aesthetics, the cuteness, all the crazy shit with the Wonder Seeds. And then this is on my docket to play for stream. I know a lot of people have been asking me to play this game. but it's one of these two, bar none. And you know me, Zelda boy. But this is basically the same art style as Breath of the Wild, so it's not like innovative or anything. This is innovative. score and music. I feel like Hi-Fi Rush has to win this.
Yeah. It's not even fair.
Again, love the music in Tears of the Kingdom. It's either this or I think the next one is audio design. This bar none should win because it's literally the game mechanic.
Yeah.
It's winning one of those two for sure. Best performance, Ben Star Final Fantasy 16. We got Star Wars, Idris Elba, Melanie Lieber for Alan Wake 2. Neil Newborn, who does he play? Is he Estarion? don't know. And Yuri for...
You're speaking real gibberish.
That's Baldur's Gate.
Yeah, Neil Newborn is Asterion.
Okay. And then Yuri for Peter Parker. Innovation and accessibility. Just, you know, different accessibility.
Can I just say Yuri sounds a lot like Bakugo when he's angrying it up as a symbiote?
It's just that light tenor that matches. It's like Michael Solosad kind of sounds like Johnny Youngbosch. Games for Impact. This is a game that I saw a bunch of that I never played. Tachiya. Kind of, sort of, Breath of the Wild inspired. Best ongoing.
Not with the Breath of the Wild stuff.
Never. Never. What deserves to win this best ongoing?
Deserves is Cyberpunk. The turnaround on that game is insane. Probably. What will win is Genshin Impact.
Should is Cyberpunk win for best ongoing when it's not really an ongoing game? It just dropped a DLC.
Well, I mean, I guess if I were to look at the way that game has progressed, like, sure, the game came out, but the game came out as a 0.5, not a 1.0. So they rebuilt the game, fixed everything, had multiple patches to change up content, and then dropped the actual, you know, it wasn't even a DLC. It was like a true on expansion with 2.0 of the game dropping. I mean, I feel like Cyberpunk's on there literally just to get handed this, it to fight against Genshin, because there's nothing else that's going to come close.
No Man's Sky should have been there. No Man's Sky.
Wasn't No Man's Sky there last year?
Best community
was Genshin Impact not?
That's what I'm trying to say. Genshin's going to continuously win.
No Man's Sky is in best community support, as well as Cyberpunk.
What?
Modding.
Best independent game, Cocoon, Dave the Diver, Dread, Sea of Stars, Viewfinder. I like Sea of Stars a lot, but I think just from everything that I've heard about it, and I've not yet played it yet, I think Dave the Diver's got this.
It will win. It's a very good game.
There is one other thing to talk about. I was going to say, especially with Gerard the Completionist being in this, a feature cameo in this game.
Yikes. I forgot about that.
Best debut indie game, Cocoon, Dredge, Pizza Tower, Venba, and Viewfinder. I've heard a lot about Pizza Tower. Best mobile game. Oh boy. Next. Best VR AR. Oh boy. Next. Best action game, Armored Core, Dead Island 2, Ghost Runner, Hi-Fi Rush, and Remnant 2. This one?
Dead Island 2 should win.
I was going to say, a lot of these were highly praised, though. So, honestly, I think any of these probably could win it. Best action adventure. But Alan Wake 2, Spider-Man 2, Resident Evil 4, Star Wars Jedi Survivor, and Zelda. Zelda should win this. Best RPG, Baldur's Gate 3, Final Fantasy 16, Lies of P, Sea of Stars, Starfield. Again, love this game to death. Baldur's Gate 3 is going to win this.
Starfield should not come anywhere close.
Best fighting
Starfield
game.
Starfield is not a good game.
No, it is bad.
God of Rock, Mortal Kombat 1, Nickelodeon All-Star Brawl 2. They snuck in there. Pocket Bravery and Street Fighter 6. I'm assuming Street Fighter 6 is going to take this hands down.
Mortal Kombat shouldn't even be on that.
It's a
bad game.
Oh, no.
The gameplay is good, but it's just really broken. It's a really broken game. There's bugs everywhere. The monetization, it doesn't deserve to be there.
$12 fatalities.
And they had to look back on it and just go, hey, you get all the seasonal fatality. But then again, we're talking $100 Ninja Turtle stuff in Street Fighter 6.
Starfield is the Skyrim of gray games. Best Family, Disney Illusion Island, Party Animals, Pikmin 4, Sonic Superstar, Super Mario Bros. Wonder. Mario's going to win that hands down. Best Sim Strategy, Advance Wars, Cities Skylines 2, Company of Heroes.
About some Sim Strategy.
Fire Emblem Engage, Pikmin 4. I'm assuming Pikmin 4 is going to win that. Best Sports / Racing. I love that they have to combine these. EA Sports, FC 24, F1 to 23, Forza Motorsports, Hot Wheels Unleashed 2 Turbocharged, the cult classic, and the crew Motorfest. I'm assuming Forza.
Can we bring back EA Big, please?
Weren't they the ones who made NBA Street?
They made NBA Street, SSX, NFL Street, anything that was more arcadey. It came from EA Big.
Can we get yearly burnout games?
Best multiplayer.
I take bi-yearly at this point. Yeah.
Best multiplayer, Baldur's Gate, Diablo 4, Party Animal, Street Fighter 6, Super Mario Bros. Wonder. Honestly, I can see this being kind of a toss-up, just like if you're going by strictly the multiplayer aspects of the games.
Best Diablo's trash.
Best adaptation, Castlevania Nocturne, Gran Turismo, The Last of Us, The Super Mario Bros. Movie, and Twisted Metal. I'm assuming
The Last of Us is going to win. Twisted Metal should win.
Yeah, I feel like it's one of these three.
Mario should not win.
It's of what's listed, I don't think these two have a shot at all. It's one of these three has a shot at a minimum. And I think at this point, the most anticipated game, I'm pretty sure Final Fantasy is going to win it. Wait, of this list, what is your most anticipated game? What's I'm assuming DA is right her.
Final Fantasy, Hades 2, Like a Dragon, Star Wars Outlaws, Tekken 8.
It'd probably be Tekken 8 for me.
Zero. Not a fucking one of them.
I don't like Young Yu's
portrayal of Kiryu.
Yeah, it's horrible.
It's not great. Especially
just play it in Japanese. Problem solved.
I want Ichiban in English! I wish you could switch the character.
That's too much.
Switch per character. I'd love that. Just make him Japanese and everybody else English.
There was a fighting game that you could do that. I forget what it was.
Marvel vs. Capcom 3.
Blaze Blue. Blaze Blue you could do it too. Cross tag.
I'm sure
Final Fantasy for me.
You did it as well. But yeah, that's not happening.
Why not?
That's not happening.
Oh, give boy. Content Creator of the Year. 2200 Productions.
Anyways, nobody gives a fuck.
I'm assuming it's the VTuber. Just if I had to take a seat.
Being that I was in a call yesterday and four people mentioned how much they love Iron Mouse. Yeah, it'll be Iron Mouse.
Yep. Oh, and I think we're just.
Oh, in. Her? What was that, sir? Grunt.
Explain.
What are we doing, sir?
Yeah, explain.
It's just I don't like her more risque types of humor in terms of that. And a lot of hers is just boobs. I'm saying the F word. And that's the joke. And that's the thing. And I just don't like
which
that.
F word?
The good F word.
Okay.
Oh, we have to say that. Oh, we have to say that.
Mother good F word!
Oh, that's... Where are we as a culture? Genuinely.
Because there are people that just... They gravitate
as a culture, man.
Humor.
Where are we?
I don't like that her horns twitch. That is a statement that was said in chat. All right, but yeah, the rest of it's, you know, esports and what have you. And I kind of get mad, especially now that I'm into more like watching competitive fighting games and stuff like that. That like basically every single FCG esports player is just snubbed always.
Every year. It's always MOBA people. It's always shooter people. Like,
that's where the money is. It's where the views are.
Is that all we're counting, or are we counting
that's
the
it.
Best in your field?
Mm-hmm.
Nope. Money and views. That's it. Who makes the money? Who gets the views?
Like, like I almost want them to like split it by category, like category of game, just to give some of these other people shine, at least. I'm pretty sure for
best in dodging Nintendo lawsuits.
I'm pretty sure for the streamies.
Smash.
True. I'm pretty sure for the streamies, they do that, where it's just like best FCG content creator,
FCG?
Best FCG player. Because I know
grass. FCG.
Fresh cut grass. That's why he's doing
FGC,
it.
FGC, sorry.
Yep.
Sorry.
He's quoting Critical Role without meaning to. Good job, Mike.
Yep. FGC fighter, FGC streamer, what have you. Because I know, like, Mango and Hungrybox have won one of those two. I think it was content creator, because they're both pretty big on Twitch. But, like, but it's, like, at least it gives people, like, those folks, like Sonic Fox and what have you, some spotlight. But, yeah, unless, I guess there's the Gerard stuff, which... There's still a lot coming.
Collar.
Yeah, a lot of stuff coming out about that. Basically, long story short, he has had a charity that has been taking money for donations towards, is it just Alzheimer's. Disabilities? What was it? Sorry?
Alzheimer's.
Oh, no, Alzheimer's.
Dementia, sorry.
For dementia. basically, for research in order to combat dementia. And it turns out that he never paid a dime to the charities. From the reports that we've been seeing, he hasn't actually used any of the money. It's just kind of chilling. And that's it. But it's been chilling there for like 6 years.
Yeah, that's not good enough.
As he's coming on stream and going, we've helped these charities and these people and these these afflictions. And you just really haven't.
There's a speculation that they put it in a like high interest account and are trying to accrue high interest on it before they donate it all as one big lump sum. So it just accrues over 6 years, just hundreds of thousands, and it's just like
I can see it.
But like, hey, maybe say that instead of we're helping.
We're doing the thing. But you're not doing the thing. Yeah. Tope's doing the thing.
Mm-hmm. But, and I know just more information is going to be coming out about that, but I know as far as, like, some of his last YouTube videos and or streams and what have you, comments, hella disabled.
Oh, yeah. Very fast.
And just not interacting with the community on it as of yet. I think he gave a statement... but hasn't really given anything since.
Which is smart. If you can't create a good enough lie to get over it, don't let the conversation spill over.
No, yeah, that lawyer went, shut it down.
There's really nothing that you can say.
Yeah.
It's there, and I'm not using it.
Yeah.
Well, that's still technically fraud because you're saying it's going to a thing that it is yet to go through over years.
It was just like, we're looking for a good enough charity. It's like, okay.
Then stop naming the charities you're contributing to.
If you're streaming to tens to hundreds of thousands of people, surely they would know good enough charities and they could offer that, but you're not even asking because people are assuming that the money's already gone to a good charity.
Guess he did not complete the transaction of money.
Yikes.
I saw all that stuff was going up, it popped up again. There you go. Good job, meme. There was a long time ago, there was this dating sim that some fans created of all the normal boots guys, including names such as Gerard the Completionist, Pro Jared, Jontron, or you could date them, and it's like...
Whoops.
This game is terribly dated at this point.
We're patching out this person. We're patching out this person.
At that point,
we no longer have a game.
It's just Peanut Butter Gamer. That's all you can do.
For now.
Yeah, true. Like, no one is safe. No one is fucking safe.
I think Peanut Butter Gamer had something happen to him not too long ago.
Nothing that was that newsworthy. Like, how hard is it to not do scummy shit? How hard is it?
When you're in a position, I just watched a documentary on Jarrett Fogle. When you've got the money and the clout, you probably watched the same one I did then.
That man was just slinging like it wasn't nothing.
Like it was going out of style.
But it's just the, I'm not going to get caught, so I could just do whatever I want.
Mm-hmm.
They feel like they're untouchable, and for a large part of whatever's going on, they are largely untouchable.
Mm-hmm.
There was this dude that was going, that was running this highly illegal TV streaming thing through, I think it was through
Cody. I know who you're talking about. Yeah,
and he had gotten millions in like a year or two. And then, you know, they just cracked down on him, and it was just like, you're facing like 500 years in prison, homie.
And he was like, you know, movies are different. I wasn't doing movie. TV shows are like a whole different copyright, and you can stream those things. And it's like, no, homie. That's not how it works.
Well, yeah. Unless there's anything else anybody wants to mention, we can wrap up.
Too late to mention anything.
I did have some things, but it's we're already 30 minutes over. We're facting it up, and we're backing it up.
All right.
30 facts about French.
Oui, oui. What?
The
French?
The.
Oh, God.
We already had the monkey swinging.
Three.
The last time, and it was literally because they thought he was a Frenchman.
The trois.
That was what, 3 years ago?
Internet no, time?
Sank. Set, on the sank set, on deux, quatorze. I remember how to count in French.
Why?
I took French.
I only remember up to six.
I took Spanish. Ask me anything.
On deux, trois, quatre, cinq, six, sept,
huit, neuf, dix. But that was Highland Park High Spanish, which was horrible. It was taught by the gym teacher.
And I think I just went on a website where they were like, hey, learn Spanish. It was terrible.
Did someone say 12?
Yep.
Huacas.
In France, during World War II, prostitutes would charge more money if they had syphilis. That's because a soldier contracting the disease would get 1 month off in a hospital and escaping the harsh conditions of the trenches.
I'd rather my itch than my neck getting slit.
Yeah,
it's
like
cold out there.
You know.
My neck is warm.
And you got some.
doesn't syphilis affect the brain?
Is getting more money as well.
Yeah, you know, if your doctors are good enough.
Except America.
It's like, and
hopefully
you know,
the war.
But that's a maybe, Ralph, where it's like maybe it'll infect the brain and you'll be off a month, or your brain gets infected with a bullet while you're in the trenches.
Yeah, there's.
So.
But then again, if they ship you back home and your family just like, what's wrong with you? They know what's up.
No, they just gave me a month off. You know,
yeah. No,
you could end up paralyzed and a vegetable from that shit. That is not a word.
You could end up you could end up paralyzed going to an outhouse back in those days.
But you could also not.
Uncultured swine of a civilization. Who gives a
what?
They were using leeches.
Yeah, there was a speed record for cutting off mom's legs.
Like, what do you want?
Speed record for cutting off the legs.
Dude, I've re-listened to that like 20 times. It's probably my favorite bit of the year from I can't stop listening to it.
I legitimately loved it.
No, you loved Ook Ook Noose Noose.
Oh, that was one of my favorite.
So streams for next week.
Absolutely.
Nothing tomorrow.
Honestly, the last Uno stream we did, I went and rewatched that in its entirety.
It's
and I
so
swear
good.
To God,
it's
the last so Uno stream good. Was unfucking hinged.
Here it comes. Here it comes.
Here it comes. Makes me laugh so hard,
dude.
Because it's so defeated.
No. I think one of the top three moments, I can't know where it lands, but I know it's top three is, you know, a plus two in the grand scheme of what I was expecting isn't that bad. What the fuck is this?
I went back to like everyone's stream and was just watching the different perspectives of everything. Here it comes. Cause like a lot of your laughter got cut out by Discord.
Oh, yeah. I was dying.
But
good stuff. Broke, bro.
I'm gonna be trying to queue some stuff up here in the next week for all the stuff that I haven't uploaded as of yet.
Also, we're probably gonna we should add our favorite moments from us when we do the year end list.
True.
There were some great moments this year.
Yes. Oh boy.
Group content always brings the best fucking moments.
Speaking of which, there will be no group content this week. So in terms of streams, Tuesday trials. I'll be doing some Resident Evil on Wednesday. No group stream because Thursday's Thanksgiving, and then I will still be out of town on Friday unless you guys want to do something. I can't. I'll be busy. I should be back by Sunday for the podcast. So if you guys are available, we should still be able to have the podcast next week as well.
Yeah, I got a long weekend off. I got Thursday and Friday off. So I'm
same.
I'm off Thursday through Sunday. I'm good.
Yep. All right.
Corporate life, baby.
Off if I really wanted it.
Oh, if I had vacation time, dude, I have people that are gone from tomorrow to next Wednesday.
Jesus Christ.
Because our vacation time doesn't roll over, so people have just been banking it up, and now they're like, fuck it, I got a month left to kill this shit.
Yeah.
I ain't coming in.
I'm probably going to take half a Tuesday off to get some shopping done. I'll probably work from home, and then just take half a Tuesday off.
I had to just because... Shocker! I'm out of sick time. No, I work
in office. It's just my job is basically like, hey, it's a soft come in unless there's some bullshit going on.
Yeah,
I honestly think I got a raise because I was the only person that came back after the internet went out for like an hour, and everybody else was like, "Yeah, we're just gonna work from home," and I still went in.
I feel you. Yeah, I get you, trust me.
I originally had just the last week of the year off, had scheduled it all out, but a shocker, I am out of sick days, and I had to take some days off last week because I was sick. So I had to use one of my vacation days as a sick day, and now I have to... It's my work from home day, but I have to sign in the last Thursday of the year. No one's going to be fucking on. I'm just going to be online just looking at my computer screen and probably just...
Mad about it.
Jiggle my touchpad. Be like, yep, still on.
Oh no! What I do is, I'll put something a little heavy, like a drink, like a bottle drink, or like the J key. Let
it go. That's thinking with portals.
You know.
I like it. I like it.
If like I was any more of an engineer, I would have like built like a contraption to like clamp onto my laptop that's just like on a timer of like every like minute, you got just like
Homer Simpson's.
Hit the space bar. Oh boy. All right. With that, we will call this podcast a close. Thank you everybody for tuning into this episode of the Podcast of Stuff. We will see you next week.
Maybe. Later.
See ya.